In this video, we will have a look at Celtics and how you can create and manage projects. If you've never seen Celtics before, it's a browser-based writing application, which means it's in the cloud and you can access your writing from any device via the browser, although there are also apps that you can use if you wish. It has a subscription-based model, but there's also a free version that lets you do quite a bit, and that can be enough for your writing depending on what you want to do. In any case, you can give it a spin and see if it's for you. You need to create an account first, and then once you've done that, you need to create a project. When you do that, it asks you what kind of project you want to create. If you don't have any projects yet because you just signed up, it should automatically ask you that. You can create different types of projects with Celtics. You have the choice between film and TV, game and VR, multi-column AV, which means audiovisual, and stage play. So in my case, I will choose film and TV. Now we give the project a name, and then we can choose whether this is going to be an episodic project, namely a television show, or if we just want to create one single screenplay. I'll leave this at film/one episode. Then, if you already have something written in another writing application, you can import that here now, where it says upload. Then you just click create project. Now what you see is an overview of your project, because in Celtics, your project doesn't just consist of your screenplay. Over the years, Celtics has evolved into a media production solution, if you will. So it offers you a lot more than just writing your scripts. So let's look at what we have here. By the way, depending on what subscription plan you're on, these functions that you have might change quite a bit. So if it looks different on your end, don't worry. This video is not about explaining you everything there is right now, because that would be way too much. I just want to show you what writing functions you have and where you can find them. So let's look at the project structure for a second. You see these little horizontal sections where it says write, plan, shoot, and so on. These are your project sections where you can find different functions for different steps of your projects. If we swivel them open for a second, just to see what we have here, you can see that all these different blocks appear that give you access to certain production functions. Of course, right now we're not interested in that. We just want to write our script, because before we can produce anything, we need a script, right? So the script is way at the top. And in case you don't see your script block because the writing area is closed, just click this little arrow at the right side and there you have all your writing functions. Apart from the script itself, you get also an index cards feature for outlining or whatever you want to use it for, and a storyboard feature. We will look into all of these in more detail another time, but for now just know that they are there and that they are available on the free plan. One more thing before we go to the script itself. You see these navigation breadcrumbs at the top of the screen where we have this little house, and next to it you see the name that you gave your project. If you click on the house, you'll be taken to the project overview where you can see all the projects that you have stored in this Celtics account right now. If you click the little check mark at the left side of the project, you get some functions at the top to manage your project, like renaming, creating folders, duplicating, and so on and so forth. You can also archive your project, so it is still there, but you don't see it in this project overview anymore, so it's kind of out of the way. And at the left side in the menu bar under projects, you can see the number of projects you have and the number of archived projects you have. Just be aware that at the time of this recording, the free plan lets you only have 2 projects, and it also counts the archived projects and the ones in the trash. Just something you should be aware of. All right, now we know how projects work. So in order to get to our screenplay, just click on the project name and then click on screenplay, and then your script will open in a new tab and you can begin to write brilliant stuff.